Will robots take your job? Well, the short answer is yes. Yes, they will. At least the way that your job works right now. We don't have to go that far to prove this point either. All we need to do is look at China and the way that robots are impacting the manufacturing and the output. And in today's video, I want to kind of give you a sneak preview. We're going to look at the numbers of the robotics integrations in China because it is absolutely shocking. And that's what I do on this channel. I'm covering the newest and latest news when it comes to robots and AI so that you can be informed, because this is directly going to impact me and your ability to feed our families, to provide for our wives, the need to stay relevant, respected, and financially free in this new world is incredibly important to me. I'm not so much scared of the Terminator. I'm more scared of mass layoffs and the inability for men like you and me to feel relevant, respected, and financially free. That's important to me. And that's why I'm here Monday through Saturday, bringing you the freshest AI robotic news. But let's look at China, okay? Because I think this is really important. CEO Ford, Jim Farley, just returned from a trip to China. And he specifically went there to see their manufacturing facilities in person. And he said it is, quote, the most humbling thing he has ever seen. And guys, just hold on for a second. We're going to talk numbers about how many robots and what the robots are doing. You are going to be floored. We'll get to that in just a moment. Because as a result of all these robots, China now produces 70% of the world's EV vehicles. Side note, the CEO, Jim Farley of Ford, said that he brought home one of those electric vehicles. And he says he doesn't want to send it back because it's such an awesome vehicle. So not only are they using robots to be more efficient, but they're using these robots to produce the highest quality product, the most technologically sound product in the world. That is what is possible when you implement all this robotic, digital integration, etc. Now, China has what are called dark factories. Have you ever heard of a dark factory before? If you've heard about it, put it in the comments below. But what these dark factories are essentially nearly 100% automated factories. There are no humans in these factories. In fact, they don't even use light, which is why they call them dark factories. Maybe there's like a little light in the corner, or maybe a night light, but there are no lights, guys, because the robots don't need the lights. The robots can operate without it. So they're able to be more efficient. And they have these dark factories. Have you ever heard of anything like that? Have you ever seen anything like that? Is this like a Black Mirror episode that we are living through right now? It sure feels like it to me. And as a result of these efficiencies, they're able to produce the highest quality product. Now, I want to just kind of take a quick step back, and we're going to talk about the numbers here for just a moment. But please recognize that we're in a global market, guys. You may say, well, we don't want robots because a robot can't do what I do. Humans have rights. We need jobs. And that's a fine perspective to take. But guys, we're in a global market. We are in a competition with China right now, okay? And we'll talk about that in just a moment. Hold that thought. Let's talk numbers here for just a moment, okay? So how many robots has China currently deployed in their manufacturing sector? Well, it's funny you ask. They currently have 10 times the number of manufacturing robots in China than we have in the US. In 2024, they installed, get this, over 500,000 new robots. Over 500,000 robots were installed in factories in 2024, 54%, excuse me, that's globally. Now, 54% of those robots were installed in China, 295,000, okay? So in 2024, 295,000 robots were installed in Chinese factories. Do you know how many were installed in US factories? 34,200. 34,200. They 10x'd our number of robots. Now you might say, well, Mark, that's because all the manufacturing is happening in China. It's not happening in the United States. Is that a good thing? Do you think that if we fight automation and robotics, that'll make us more competitive? Just asking. And you may disagree, and you're welcome to put your comments below. That's where I feel like I get a lot of the best ideas. But China is eating our lunch, boys. They are eating our lunch. And if we think that the best way to fight and compete with China is by becoming less efficient, I don't know that that's a good strategy. Frankly, I don't know that the whole tariff thing is going to work out well either. I don't think we need the government interfering. I think we need to produce the best product as efficiently as possible, period. And the robots are working. Right now, there are, in China, over 2 million manufacturing robots. Guys, 2 million manufacturing robots already working on the lines in China. Guys, that is more than the entire world combined. There are more robots in China than the entire world combined when it comes to manufacturing. Isn't that an insane number? I just find that mind-blowing. There are 394,000 in the US. There are more manufacturing robots in China than the entire world combined. That's crazy. And guys, when we look at what, you know, we tend to really only understand what we've got right in front of our faces. But if you go over to China, like these CEOs are, they are being blown away by what's happening with robotics overseas. Let's look at how many robots they have per manufacturing workers. So when we look at robots per 10,000 manufacturing workers, in China there are 470 robots per 10,000. In the United States, we have 280 robots per manufacturing workers. Do you think that number will increase over the years? Do you think there's gonna be more or less robots in the future in the United States? Real question, real talk, guys. How do you think that impacts your job? How do you think that impacts the economy overall? Do you think that that's gonna create new problems to solve? And I've been pretty vocal on this, guys. When it comes to solving problems, the problems you're solving today are not gonna be the problems you're solving in 10 years, even in 5 years. More on that in just a moment. Hold on for me, hold on. Stay with me here, guys. I wanna keep going through these numbers here. Because the reality is, China is not stopping. In fact, they plan to double the amount of robots they have by 2028. There's this thing that kind of happens with growth and productivity. It's not linear, it's exponential. So as they get more robots, they can use the robots to build more robots, and they're gonna be exponentially more efficient. It's gonna be tough to compete with that. It's gonna be tough to compete with that. You know, in China, China's a communist country, guys. You don't have property rights in China. So how are they, let me back it up. How are they able to do this? They're a communist country. In the US, we have a lot of different barriers in place. We have property rights, we have unions, we have lawyers, permits, approvals, systems. In China, they say, we want to build a train station, your home is forfeit, it's given to the state now. They don't care. In the United States, we have property rights, guys. You don't have property rights in China. How do you compete against that? I don't think that seems like a better, higher quality of life. Just as a quick side note, humans are not reproducing in general, but that's a problem over in China. They need to use these robots to replace the human labor because the people aren't reproducing. They had the one child policy, then they bumped it up to two. They've got a bunch of issues here with their reproduction rates. And as a result, robots become even more of a necessity. Maybe that's kind of a darker agenda on the world stage. What do you think, guys? I don't want to go conspiracy theory here, but more robots, less humans, less babies, PSYOP. I don't want to go too conspiratorial here, but what I do know for sure is that robots are here, more robots are coming. And when it comes to this barriers in the United States, I recorded an entire video on this a couple days ago. I'll post a link to it here. The guys from the All In podcast were talking about these data center projects that are trying to be approved here in the United States. Google, Microsoft, Nvidia, they're trying to build these data centers so that we can stay in the lead of software, because we might be losing on the robot front, but we are winning on the software front. At any rate, they want to build these data centers, but they can't because communities keep saying they don't want them. We don't want them in our backyard. I covered this entire video. Check out that video. It's a little bit longer, but I think you'll appreciate the conversation here. Because what they realize, and I think what we need to understand too, is that we're not working within a vacuum of the United States here when it comes to building these data centers, these software hubs, this infrastructure, manufacturing, warehousing, all that. We're competing on a global scale, and our competitors, China, are deploying robots like mad. They don't have to worry about a community saying, no, we don't want the data center. China just does it. They don't have to say, we don't want a nuclear reactor in our backyard. We've seen Chernobyl. China just does it. They just do it. Think about that. Think about that. How does that impact your job? How does that impact your community? How does that impact the problems that we're facing now versus the problems we're going to be facing in 5 years? Where do you fit in to help solve those problems? That's all I think about is, where can I be of value? What are the problems that I'm solving now versus what I'll be solving in the future? We'll get to that in a moment. You know, can we even compete? Can you compete with a robot that's efficient? Can you compete? If not, should we be using more robotics in our manufacturing plants? If we can't compete with robots, should we be using more robots in our workspaces now so that we can compete with China? You know, look, like I said, guys, it's easy to say we don't want robots, we need jobs, but we are in this global economy. I think this is a really important conversation that isn't being appropriately discussed. What can we do? I've doom and gloomed you for a bit here, but what can we do? Because I like to live in this world of reality, and you know, listen, I know some of you guys disagree with me, that's fine. But to me, it's inevitable that these robots, this AI, is coming. So I don't want to necessarily fight that. I want to be part of it. I want to find ways that I can solve these problems so I can be relevant, respected, and financially free, so I can provide for my family. My kids need me. Your kids need you. You're going to need to adapt. So let's not think about being competition to robots. Let's think about being complementary to robots. How can you be complementary to a robot? How can you upskill? Can you invest in continuous education? Huawei is a private company in China, as private as you can get, and they've built a massive research center in Shanghai with the purpose of educating 35,000 engineers. They're going deeper and harder and stronger on this technology. And I think the same way. We need to be focused on upskilling. It's not a time to get comfortable. You know, I'm in marketing, just on a quick side note, and we've been looking for some innovative new trends, some innovative new ways to grow our clients' portfolios. And one of the big, fresh, shocking new ways to do that is with AEO, Answer Engine Optimization. Basically, that's, how do you get your company recommended by ChatGPT and by Claude and by Gemini and Perplexity and all these platforms? And it's requiring me to learn a lot. But I believe that these new skills are gonna serve me over the next 2 years. They're gonna serve me. We have success with one client, then I can replicate that for 2 to 4 clients, and then we can start to build out systems to serve clients. AEO, Answer Engine Optimization, was not a thing 2 years ago. Now it's a thing. I need to learn. I need to adapt. The stuff I was doing yesterday is not necessarily going to be what I'm doing tomorrow. That's the mentality, boys. Because the reality is that, and I just read this today, I thought this was interesting, the half-life of a technical skill is not 10, 20 years anymore, it's 2.5 years. So you learn a skill, it's gonna be basically on the outs within 2.5 years. That means you need to be continuously upskilling. And you might not like that, but that's the reality that we live in, boys. Think about, what are the higher value roles? You're not gonna be just lifting heavy boxes and moving them. You're not gonna be digging holes anymore. I saw a guy earlier today, he was laying out mulch. In 10 years, you're not gonna be laying out mulch. There's gonna be a robot doing that. How can you adapt? How can you leverage that technology to be more efficient? Maybe instead of doing one house a day and selling one house a day, maybe you sell 10 homes and you mulch 10 homes a day because you have your robot assistant. You have your robot employees to serve you. I know that sounds scary. I know that sounds crazy, but just think about how much more efficient you could be, how much more you could provide. Now, all of a sudden, instead of laying the mulch, you're shaking hands and kissing babies and finding people to sell your services to, and you have your robot fleet to assist you. That's exciting to me. That's exciting to me. Think about the relationships now, guys, not before it's too late. And I know I talk about this a lot, but connect with others. I don't know if you think, should we start a community for all the other men who are working to remain relevant, respected, and financially free? Should we start some sort of community? I've been thinking about it. Now, at this point, some of these videos, I had a video the other day, got 600 comments on it. Should we build a community where guys can stick together and look for opportunities for each other? Is that interesting to you? Put in the comments below if that's interesting to you. I already have my newsletter, AIUpdate.ai, which is totally free. You can go to AIUpdate.ai. But should we have some sort of community where we can get together? Been thinking about it. Because the relationships that we have matter. We got to look out for each other because things are going to get messy, boys. They're going to get messy. The last thing I would point out here is ownership and low debt. Pay off the debt, try to own stuff, assets, not liabilities. Your car is a liability. That's where I'm at. Guys, if you liked today's video, thanks for liking, subscribing, appreciate that. I will see you in the next video. I'll post a link to it right here, because the robot wars are not over. The robots in China are happening, but they are happening here too. The manufacturing robots are in China. The warehouse delivery robots are here in the United States, because that's what we need. We need our Amazon packages. My wife needs her Amazon today. 600,000 jobs plan to be displaced over the next 6 years by Amazon. By 2033, 600,000 robots will be working jobs of humans. Check out yesterday's video. It will shock you. All right, boys, I'll see you there. Peace.